Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Now, this video is not all Lord's Mole related, but it is Lord's Mole emphasized. That means it's not just for Lord's Mole, it's for any kind of game. You might be able to play this, but in case you might have realized by the title, or I'm too dumb to even make a good title for this video, but whatever. This video is going to be covering how I'm able to continue playing a game or grinding a game past whatever makes the game easy or past whatever is, you know, reasonable. You know, I've been playing this game for 5 years now and I have yet to fully quit the game. I still come back right now. I'm coming back very consistently to actually playing and being part of rallies and events and stuff like that whenever I have free time, you know, because life happens. We all know this. Now, a lot of people have been asking me this. People are like my friends, how my friends that play Sinodis with me, they started playing the game a couple weeks before me, and then I came in. Some of those friends already got bored of the game. They already quit because they got to a point that they couldn't progress anymore, and it took them forever. I got to that point very soon because I grind the game a lot, but I'm still going at it. I'm still improving the game. I'm still getting better. I'm still getting bigger. And they've asked me, how do you do it? How are you able to focus on a game or play a game without getting bored? That is the question, right? How do you play a game without getting bored? This includes me playing League of Legends for the past 8 years now, so I'm not getting bored of it. Though I don't play it consistently enough though nowadays, but I still like it whenever I have free time. I play it, you know. Minecraft is a new one. You can get really bored of Minecraft if you're not doing stuff, right? So that's the point of this video. I wanna share with you guys what I do. Now, the basics. Basic, bare minimum that I would do whenever I start playing a game, I set myself a goal. I usually play for fun. Whenever it's play for fun, I don't care if I like the game. I don't keep playing the game unless it's with friends, because that's the only time I play a game for fun, just with friends. I never play a game for fun by myself. Unless there's certain games I do, but it's very rare. Maybe something like Dark Souls. But because there's no multiplayer, right? But what I do is I set myself a goal. The reason I set myself a goal is because it gives me something to focus on. Lords Mobile, there's a lot of things you can do in the game that if you spread yourself thin by doing everything, you will accomplish nothing. By this, I'm talking about research. Research, you have Monster Hunt gear, then you have War research, then you have Hyperion research. Now, if you want to like do a little bit of everything, it will take you about 2 years to get the bare minimum basics of those research complete. When you start the game. Now, this means 3 years times you'll finally be able to hunt level 4 monsters, you'll finally be able to max out your hyper production, and you'll finally be able to get also a tier 4 or tier 3 with a lot of tier 4 research completed, right? Because we're still talking 2 years of not paying money. You're paying money, you might progress your speed a lot faster, right? This is talking about free to play mainly, because that's the way I play all my games, free to play. Now, knowing this, the reason you set a goal is starting Lords Mobile. You guys have not seen a video. I made a video a couple times back about how to build an alt account. And the first thing I ask is, how do you want to build the alt account? Do you want to make it into a trap account? If you want to make it into a trap account, you focus all the research on military. If you want to make it a hyper account, you focus all your research on economic and the familiar research, because you know that gives research protection. If you want to be a monster hunting with research production, then you go basic hunting and then max out hyper production and then max out monster hunting. And that is focusing yourself down to setting to your research. This also goes to what you're going to do for your gear. This goes to what you're going to do with your troop comp. If you're going to build a troop comp, what kind of research you need to do. So doing this, knowing where you want to focus on, where your end goal is the way I continue playing a game. So my first end goal for the game was to be a Darkness Rally Lead. That's when I started playing the game. I was in a guild, TSE, the Sunshire, I believe, was something like that. I honestly forget the name. I'm still friends with the old guild leader. We still talk a lot. He's been with me in this guild. Now, back then, we're talking about 5 years ago, the game had very little big people. 1 billion was already top 10. It was already number top 10. We only had Benjong at 10 billion might. Then the next person was at 2 billion. Then the next person was at 1 billion. And then everyone else was below that. That was 5 years ago. Now we know about, you need about 10 billion might to be the top 10 in the world, right? But back then, nobody knew anything. Started a kingdom 276 or 276, I think that's the number of the kingdom. I don't remember. It's been 5 years. It's been a while, right? So what I did is I invested 2 months, 3 months of me testing out rallies, darkness rallies. I'll do every darkness rallies. So when I was playing at that time, there wasn't many videos on how to rally. There wasn't many videos on how to counter. What kind of troop comps. There was nothing about the four troop fodder, and there wasn't much information on five one troop type heroes or four heroes and an army hero kind of tactics. That wasn't talked about. That was in common conversation in non-major war guilds that required to spend hundreds of dollars per week. Now, I learned this all by myself in 3 weeks. I helped out by giving out resources and speed ups to my guildmates so they can speed up their healing, since I was running a good 200 to 300 darkness rallies a day for about 3 days a week, with the other days being an average of 50 rallies. And I wrote everything down. I think I did like 2 notebooks of seeing the differences on different rallies. I was with no war gear, no nothing. I wasn't doing much effort on that, since I didn't drop any money in the game at that time. So I did that, and I focused that down. Next thing I focused was monster hunting. Once I got monster hunting to maxed out for Academy level 24, then I went for familiars. And then I did a whole 6-month period. In case you guys don't know, I made the very first familiar video I made talking about familiars was after 6 months of me training, of me rebuilding, building buildings, doing different training routines, doing calculations with XP, with heroes, all that shenanigans. But that was my goal. My goal was understanding this part of the game. Then the next goal was tier 4. Now, tier 4 was granted to me thanks to a friend winning 26 million. Narmi, if you're watching my videos, if you ever watch my videos, I still thank you. I miss you. I hope I see you again in the game. Maybe one day. But yes, so I was able to hit tier 4 thanks to a guildmate of mine winning 26 million gems. I was only missing a couple months of research, and he got me there. Next thing I did was my troop comp. My main first goal was getting the 5 million tier 2 and 1 million tier 4, because I just wanted to have a very solid team comp. I reached that troop comp. Now I'm going to the next one, which is 2 million each tier 4 and 10 million each tier 2. If I got there or not, who knows? You guys might want to check my other videos where I do a review of my troop comp. Oh, so you can know how far I've gotten to that troop comp. But yes, so those are my goals. Every time I reach a goal, I make a new goal. That way I have something to focus on. Monster hunting has always been a thing for me. So I tend to be in a guild that's very desperate for monster hunting. When it comes to other games, Sinnoh Atlas wise, I recently, in case you guys don't know, Sinnoh Atlas, you have a set of weapons. That set is what you use throughout the matches that you go through. And you have about 16 that you can fit in there. I currently am a minstrel main, which means I'm a bard, right? I use instruments to buff up my allies. And I already got all my 16 instruments. That was my first goal. Now my next goal was 16 instruments, all L rank and maxed out. My next goal is what I'm focusing on next, which is maxing out every SR and L rank weapon to the max that I can. So I'm grinding out on that game little by little. The materials, the resources, the speed ups, the gold, in order to be able to accomplish that in the end of the game. In League of Legends, I really do want to play rank again in that game, but I'm not consistent. I don't consistently keep up with the patches. So what I do, I join in for an ARAM game, which are just random fun games that you play with friends. Recently, I started playing Valorant. I kind of stopped because my friends haven't invited me again to play because, you know, I suck. But whenever I have time, I play in the target practice, and I just keep practicing my aim since my aim sucks. Recently, I've been doing Minecraft with friends. We're doing the server. I might start streaming as soon once I get another ramp stick, which should be arriving sometime next week. So you like Minecraft or you like modern Minecraft or random shenanigans, you're more than welcome to join. I'll be streaming that as well as making the videos I'm planning to make. But yeah, so you gotta set yourself goals. You don't want to get bored of the game. You want to keep playing a game with your friends. Let them know about this video. Tell them they need to set themselves some sort of goal. It's not just playing a game to play the game, because you play the game to play the game, and something goes wrong, you don't want to play the game anymore. People that play the game to play the game, then they get zeroed. Well, that's it. They don't want to play anymore. They put 2 or 3 years in the game. They get hit once. They don't want to play because they didn't have a reason to play. They didn't have a goal they wanted to reach. The goal will also help you stay on time with the shields, grind out events, grind out anything you want to grind out. You just need to get yourself goals. You want to have tier 4? Set yourself goals. You're going to be doing monster hunting enough daily to where you can actually reach 1,000 gems a day, 2,000 gems a day, 6,000 gems a day. I myself, as you guys can see my gem count, I did the 20,000 gems that I was giving away. If everyone finally contacted me, I gave them away. I dropped to about 349,000. And look at me, about, what is that? Today is Tuesday, so 3 days later, I'm already up another 14,000. So this contribution of the guild, this contribution of me doing monster hunting, of me. I don't do Colosseum. I should be doing Colosseum, though. We just recently migrated. We have new targets. There's a lot of things to do, right? But you are going to focus yourself on a goal. That's the way you're going to keep yourself from not quitting a game. That's the way you don't get bored of a game. This is the way you don't quit of a game, including Lords Mobile. You set yourself a goal. You have a goal. That means you get zeroed. Don't matter. Brush it off. You're going to reach your goal. That's the point. Now, I know I already made this video long enough, but I hope if you found the information helpful, you found it helpful. And yeah, so I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.